Good morning, students. Welcome to the digital classroom with Holy Heart Schools. Students, today we are going to start up with a new chapter which is given in a geography book of class 10. Students, please open up your books on page number 155. Today our lesson is water resources, lesson number 7. Before going ahead, let's know what we are going to study in this chapter. So the objectives of this lesson are to learn about the meaning of the word water resources, to learn about main sources of water that include surface water, groundwater, lagoons and backwater, to learn about importance of irrigation in India, to learn about methods of irrigation which includes primitive method under which we will be studying about canals, tank, wells, modern methods under which we will be studying about sprinkler irrigation, drip irrigation and bamboo irrigation, about the need of the conservation of water, about rainwater harvesting, about advantages of rainwater harvesting, about areas where the rainwater harvesting is being practiced and rainwater harvesting techniques. While going through above topics, we will be learning some new words which includes natural resources, material or substance occurring in nature which can be exploited for economic gain. Agriculture means cultivation of land to grow crops. Reservoir, a large natural or artificial lake used as the source of water supply. Irrigation means watering of crops. Hydroelectricity, electricity produced by falling water. Pollution, pollution is the introduction of contaminants into the natural environment that cause adverse change. Surface water. Surface water is a water on the surface of the continent such as stream, river, lakes, etc. Groundwater. Groundwater is a water present beneath earth's surface in soil pore spaces and in the fracture of the rocks formation. Evaporation means the process of changing liquid into gas or vapor. Transpiration. Transpiration is the evaporation of water from plants. Lake. Deep depression on the earth's surface filled with water. Canals. Channels dug to carry river water to dry areas and fields. Catchment. The action of collecting rainwater, especially the collection of rainfall over a natural drainage area. Aquifer means a watery basin. So students, today our topic is our water resources, surface water and groundwater. Before going ahead with our topic, let's know what we are going to study. Let's know about the basis of the chapter. We all know that we need water for irrigation. The basic question that we are going to study in this chapter is why we need irrigation. India is basically an agriculture dominated country. Maximum number of people here are employed in agriculture operation either as landed farmers or either as the farmers who take it on rent. They are actually the tenant farmers. There are one more group of people who are engaged in the process of farm labor. For successful agriculture, the most important thing that we need is water or irrigation. Now here we have to know what are the three different ways in which water is available to the large number of agriculture operations and in general. One is of course rainfall. Where there is sufficient rainfall, there will be no shortage of water. Other is groundwater. Now here the question arises, what is groundwater? Water which is obtained from the depth of 15 meter is known as groundwater. It can be near the surface of the mainland or it can be very deep also. Third method is specially found in the states like Kerala, where we found backwater or lagoons, especially in central Kerala in the cities like Kochi. Now next we have to understand that why irrigation is so important for us. We know that in India the agriculture is the main occupation. The people here are mostly getting occupation through this agriculture. The another one is the rainfall in India is erratic and unevenly distributed. So for this we need a permanent arrangement of water. This is the reason that we need the sources for irrigation. Now let's start our topic for the day. India is a land of rich natural resources. Natural resources means the resources that we get from nature, water being one of the most vital of all. We know that three things are important for every living being to live: air, water and land. Without water, we cannot live. India being essentially means importantly an agriculture country, we need water for agriculture means cultivation of crops as well as industry. We need water to irrigate, to water our crops. We need water for the industries. We need proper water treatment plants in our industries. Water is stored as reserve means a place behind a dam or a river where the river water is stored to supply water to villages and cities. For example, Gobind Sagar Lake on the river Satluj. It is also used for irrigation means watering the crops, production of hydroelectricity. Hydroelectricity means electricity produced by falling of water, and navigation. Navigation means movement of ships. Demand for water is increasing rapidly with the increase in population, but obvious. If the population is increasing, the demand of the thing will also be increased. And if the water is essential for everyone, so the demand of water will also increase, where the supply of water remains the same. India occupies only 2.45% of the world's surface area. It is the home of 16% of the world's surface area and the home of 16% of the world's population. As against this, India has only 4%. For 16% of the world population, we have only 4% of the world water resources. Even this limited supply can be depleted or made unusable by extensive utilization, pollution and poor management of water. If we waste water, if we pollute water, we cannot use that water. So we should use water very sensibly. We receive plenty of water in short rainy season and the remaining part of the air remains dry. Under such conditions, the balance between the demand and the supply has to be maintained. So for this reason, we store water by, we can do rainwater harvesting, we can store water in the tanks and later we can use that water for irrigation or for other purposes. The main sources of the water are as follow: surface water, groundwater, lagoons and backwater. So let's start with the surface water resources in India. Surface water resources in India includes river, lakes, pond, waterfalls, etc. Whatever the water bodies are present on the surface of the land are known as surface water resources. If you can really see this figure, that 9% of the surface water are used for the domestic purposes. Domestic purposes means at homes, etc. 2% for the industrial sector and 89% for the agricultural sector. Rainfall is the main source of the fresh water. Fresh water means water which is not salty and fit for drinking in India. From precipitation. Precipitation means rain, snow, hail that falls or condenses on the ground. Including snowfall, India receives 4000 cubic kilometer means billion cubic meter water. A good part of it is lost through the process of evaporation. Evaporation means the process of changing liquid into gas or vapor. And plant transpiration. Transpiration means evaporation by the stomata present in the leaves. Large part of the water percolates means seep deep into the ground and is available to us in the form of groundwater that we will be studying later. Surface water is available on the surface of the earth in the forms of river, lakes, ponds and canals. Lakes means deep depression on the earth's surface filled with water. For example, Buller Lake. Rivers we have example like Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, etc. canals like Indira Gandhi Canal. However, and canals means channels dug to carry river water to dry areas. However, rivers comprises the most important source of the surface water. India is blessed with a large number of major, medium and small size rivers. If you can really see this figure, you can see many basins in India. Basin means an area drained by the river and its tributary. Let's talk about major basins. Indus Basin, Ganga Basin. Then we have Brahmaputra Basin, Godavari Basin, Narmada Basin, Krishna Basin, Tapi Basin. Then we have Pennar Basin, Kaveri Basin. These are the some of the most important basins in India, Mahanadi Basin. Of the major river, Ganga, Brahmaputra, Meghna system is the biggest with the catchment area of about 110 hectares. See this. This Ganga Basin complete area. Brahmaputra Basin, including river Brahmaputra and its tributaries. And Meghna Basin means here the river Meghna, which is also joining Brahmaputra. This complete area. Most of the Himalayan rivers are large and originate in the snow-covered high altitude, means height above the sea level areas of the Himalayan region. We have many rivers which have their source in Himalayas, like Ganga, Yamuna, Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Satluj, Brahmaputra and so on. As such, they carry sufficient water through the air. They are called perennial rivers. Perennial rivers means the rivers which flow throughout the air. In contrast, the rivers of the peninsular India are peninsular India, this part. They are Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri. Here I am talking about the important rivers. Seasonal. Seasonal means which flow only in a particular season. They carry no or very little water in the dry summer season. Next, our topic is groundwater. Groundwater means the part of the rainwater that seeps through the cracks and crevices into the ground is called groundwater. Crevices means a narrow opening of a rock or a wall. Groundwater represents one of the most important water sources in India and accounts for 400 cubic kilometer of annual utilization resources in India. Here I have to mention that in USA, especially in rural areas, 50% of the water that they use is the groundwater. The distribution of groundwater is very uneven in India. The presence and the availability of groundwater varies greatly with the changes in topography. Topography means natural and man-made features. Subsurface geology means the study of the physical properties and the location of rock and soil found below the ground surface and the prevailing climate in the region. Because in the coastal areas or in the alluvial tracts of the country, the water can seep down very easily. But in the peninsular India, where we are having igneous rocks like basalt, here the water can only seep down through the cracks or crevices. In some areas, groundwater exists in deep aquifers. Aquifers means watery basin, which is mostly found between the permeable rock between the two impermeable rocks, means in the porous rocks between the two non-porous rocks. While in other, the water is stored near the surface. The location of the aquifer also affects the recharge rate and the susceptibility to pollution and overuse. In general, the mountainous and the hilly regions in the north and the west India do not allow adequate infiltration. Adequate infiltration means satisfactory process by which water on the surface enters the soil, and as a consequence means result, the groundwater is mostly limited in the plains and to other low-lying areas. In the peninsular part of India, the underlying geology limits the formation of the large continuous aquifers. As a result, the overall yield potential in this region is low, that I have already explained. Coastal regions are usually rich in groundwater owing to the largely alluvial tracts. Coastal regions means the area near the sea. The alluvial tract of the Gangetic Plain, which extends over the 2000 kilometer across central and the northern India has the best potential for groundwater extraction in the country. Due to the highly variable nature of the climate, groundwater has become a popular alternative for the irrigation and the domestic water use across the country. Now, if you can see this figure again, the second one, the 3% is used for the domestic purpose, 5% in the industries, and 92% for the agriculture. In addition to being accessible means reachable, the groundwater quality is generally excellent in most areas and are present relatively safe source of drinking water for Indians in rural means in like in villages or underdeveloped areas, and urban areas means developed areas like cities. So lagoons and backwater. India has a very long coastline stretching over more than 6,000 kilometers. Coastline is basically a boundary between a coast and a water body. For you can see this. This is the complete coastline of India. And we know that we have intended coastline. Intended coastline means edged with a zigzag or to have the cuts for the inland waterways. This coast means an area near the sea is very intended. In some states, intended means edged with zigzag or half cut, like Kerala, Odisha, where the large number of lagoons have been formed. These lagoons is a shallow body of water separated from the larger water body by barren islands or by the sand hills, and lakes serve as a surface water resource. Although the quality of the water is generally brackish, means not suitable for drinking. In nature, these are used for fishing and irrigating paddy crops like rice and coconut. So students, this was our topic for the day. Please try to solve the related back question answers. So, goodbye.